Hello friends, today we are going to look at analyzing the Nifty 50 stocks using all the features of the charts which we introduced over the last few weeks. So truly combined all in one charts where you can see futures data along with options data and technical indicators and some alerts and signals on the same. So let's choose the Nifty group, and by default in the myFnO charts what you see is the price, volume and OI. Now I'm showing you how you can set up various aspects of the charts so you will get an idea. For example, if I remove volume, all I get to see is the price and the OI, and this is by default of the futures, OI futures. Now if I add all options, what I get to see is price versus OI and total OI call OI and total put OI. And let's see this for 3 months. So it shows you strike wise combined OI call versus total put OI. Let me just increase the size bigger. And if I add the OI profile, what it shows me is blue is calls versus put, purple and puts. It shows you calls versus put strike wise OI and the changes in the OI. So if it's a buildup, it'll be a thick one filled, and if it's a covering, it'll be an empty one. And I like to see this as a long shot. So when you're seeing it as a long shot, it shows you the puts in greens, showing that the put writers are strong. So it's bullish if it's rising, and the calls in reds, right? And if there is some covering, it will show you in blue. So and if there is some short covering, it is in blue. And if there's some long unwinding, it's in yellow. Likewise, the same also applies in futures. So if there's a long buildup, it's in red, long unwinding is in yellow. Short covering, essentially price rise with OI fall is in blue, and price rise with OI rise is in green. Let's make the size also bigger so it's really more easier to see. So this is what we've set up right now. Let's add even the max OI. So max OI shows you the maximum OI is on which strike. So it essentially shows you the support and the resistance zones where they are building up, right? And in case there is some unwinding of the max OI strike, it'll show you as a blue or a yellow. Essentially, it's being covered, right? And if it's some maximum OI build up on that same strike, it'll show you as a thick line, right? So to this now, let's add, say, the PCR also. So it's showing you the ratio of the OI call versus put. And I like to personally see also the OI spread, which shows you a nice neat histogram between the put and call spread. And the trend, if it's changing, it just gives you a clearer picture. To this, let's also add back the volume. And I'd like to see end of the day delivery also, which gives you how the smart money is actually building up positions in the underlying cash market also. And to this, let's add a couple of useful indicators like the standard ones, SMA, RSI, and say ADX. Okay, what we can also do is add signals to this. The signals is there in the diamond plan, by the way, where, in the platinum plan, and specific code conditions where you can custom defined signals is there in the diamond plan, and multiple charts are there in the gold plan. So here you can see a lot of signals being generated where you can actually filter, say, a price. We'll see how these can be used in the next few minutes. So you've got this setup also here. Okay, and to this also, I love to see the percentage range levels, the percentile. Essentially it shows you if it's in the extreme 5 percentile or higher or lower. So it gives you the high end sell low signals also, right? So we kind of set up here of what I want to be looking at, and let me save this as a view also, so I can call it, say, all in one. So next time I have to come back to this, I just have to choose that all in one view, and this would be ready to use. Okay, so now what we can see here, let's see some extremes. In fact, let's see where the OI is, say, at falling or rising, or say call build up and OI spread is say rising. Okay, so the call and put OI spread here, you can see the put OI is rising sharply along with the price rise, but the PCR has really gone to an extreme high, and this is at its highest percentile. PCR is in its high range. So this generally doesn't last for long, and there could be a reversal here. That's where maybe Reliance could start cooling off, right? You can see this ADX also, the gap is increasing, this which could again kind of revert. So maybe Reliance could see some cooling here. Hindalco, sharp rise in PCR, but the price is rising steadily, and you can see this OI spread is also increasing, but now the puts have kind of flattened and even the calls have flattened. Essentially it's reached a nice level, it's been rising consistently, so maybe again there could be a turnaround there, right? Then let's see, let's remove this. Let's see where there's a delivery spike, for example, here, JSW Steel, major delivery spike here also. JSW Steel, sharp rise in PCR, OI is continuously falling, okay? So there's also long and mining as well as now short covering, which has happened. So the shorts are also getting out, but the PCR is rising. And lot of unwinding which happened here at these strikes, and now the resistance zone is moved on a higher level, but there is some writing out there also. So maybe at this resistance zone, we could see some selling pressure. Titan also, major crack here, okay, with the deliveries being unmounted, but the PCR now sharply falling. You can see the spread also. The spread also is actually reduced sharply, and this gap cannot sustain for long. So maybe there could be a turnaround here back again. But some major call writing which is happening here. That's the reason for the sharp rise of red. Now, another very interesting thing which we'd like to highlight, what we've added in this long short in futures, what you can see is try to look out for streaks of red, blues, or greens or yellows. And generally, we've seen more often than not, you rarely have a condition where you have four or five together. The moment that happens, that color tends to change. Essentially, the trend can't be in a long buildup or a short buildup or a long and winding or short covering together for more than four or five trading sessions. You can see after this red, a lot of short buildup happened and it had to change, and it generally changes in another direction. And before changing another direction, it's generally a color of the same price movement but unwinding or a change. For example, it moved from red to yellow, and then from green to blue, essentially rising, and then the shorts which are built up here, it got covered here, and that's where it rose, right? Likewise here, the buildup which happened, there was long and winding here, four yellows, and the first sign of blue, it showed you that it would rise from there. And now likewise, you're gonna have, you're seeing a lot of and this blue was followed by green, so this short covering was followed by the longs building up, but the moment the price rose higher, you could see the shorts also started building up now, and there are three reds in a row. You could probably have one or maybe another second session also, but that won't last for long, and these shorts which have risen sharply could start to cover from there, right? In fact, rather than looking at one at a time, let's look at it individually also. You can see here Tata Steel rising here, so OI spread reducing, PCI high, fallen here, but that's fine. What we'll like to look for is streaks. The Reliance one, as I mentioned, see, four reds didn't last for long. There had to be a turnaround which started with the blue short covering and then greens, and then the price rose from there. Reliance again, lots of greens, blues together. Similar category, essentially long buildup or short covering, and this shouldn't last long. We suspect Reliance could correct from there. HDFC Bank, interesting. Three reds, and you can see after this greens and blues, this chunk of rise, you're seeing three reds also, which are here, which could probably, this short buildup is gone up so high, or is near the high range, and we could see some unwinding here of the shorts, essentially some cooling off and maybe some support which is forming here at the 1400 levels, which we can see also here at the support zone. And if you'd like to see, you know, you can always see the RSI and ADX or even the moving average. So there you could get an idea. Here you can see the RSI is turning around, or the ADX gap is reducing, and let's see how it turns around from there. ICICI Bank, after some major short coverings, you can see this chunk of blues. The moment it turned around, it moved to red. So this, now this, we were having a spate of red and yellows together. The trend of the falling may not last for long. TCS, lot of blues together, one red now. So maybe this could show signs of falling. The PCR has risen quite sharply, and now in the last one day, you can see the calls also getting written more stronger than the puts. So maybe signs of TCS to correct from here. Hindalco, lots of greens together, first sign of a yellow. So some unwinding here possibly, and PCI is already so high. You can see this is gone up, the spread is also reduced, and it generally wouldn't go up for long, and it should probably, all signs are showing that Hindalco might kind of correct temporarily for this expiry. HDFC, blues followed by reds, and some short build up here. PCR also falling, so let's see, actually maybe one or two more sessions again of some weakness. Dani Ports, sharp OI buildup which has happened here, first the shorts and then the greens, and but big volumes also here. So let's see how this RSI is looking stronger though. So these shorts again were countered by these bulls in green. Kotak Bank fell sharply in, you can see red and then yellow, so major short build up and just a little bit of profit booking, but big volumes and in delivery also, and you can see a lot of yellows here, so the puts being covered here, which you can see here, and in fact even the support zone of 1700 is showing you a yellow bar. So this is kind of being unwound also, the support zone. So it could show some weakness. ITC, sharp rise. It's been a smooth sailing, but now at 260, there's some major core writing at 260, 255 levels. So there could be some, in fact, you can see this thing, the blues, just a tad bit of yellow and red, and then greens also, Y build up, and then the first sign of a red build up. So maybe ITC might show some resistance here now, which you can see also the PCR also kind of turning around. SBI, okay, that's fine. Here, just showing you chunk of five blues, in fact six blues, followed by a yellow. It just showed that these were the first signs that the direction might just be changing. See, chunk of five reds, first sign of red converting to blue, and how Infi rose from there. Right? Look out for the streaks of red, blues, or greens, yellows. Very effective. Let's see. Infi rose from there. Levers. Just speaking about that. Five reds in a row. This can't last for long. The OI is really high. Major short buildup. And now you can see this OI spread also kind of reversing. PCR at its low. Really an oversold zone. In fact, you see even RSI is near 33. So Hind lever could show some bouncing back. In fact, some major build up here happening also. So these are strong support zones, and at least it could bounce back to some levels, maybe near 2000 or above. JSW Steel, big delivery volumes, sharp rise of PCR, four blues in a row. Short covering which has happened, so the blues may be changing to something. Either the short covering, if it's really strong, the trend changes from blues to greens. essentially from short covering to long buildup. So if the price keeps rising, the point is the color generally we've seen doesn't remain the same for 4 or 5 sessions in a row. It's a very interesting observation. So if it goes up stronger from here, it'll again start converting to green if the OI also builds up. But since it's risen so sharply here, suspect there might be some cooling off here also. So let's see. Titan, which we had seen before and in the earlier part of the video. 3 big reds and sharp fall. So maybe it's an oversold zone and it could rise from there. Wipro, chunk of 5 blues, intermediary red, but the blue is now turning to yellow. So the OI falling and now you can see it's kind of price is flattening. So maybe, yeah, there could be some sliding down here also. RSI also kind of cooling off and looking to move down. Maruti, see the similar cases, 4 reds in a row. It's easy to see with the colors, you know, that yeah, the pattern, 4 chunks in a row move from red to a green, showed a turnaround from there. See how Maruti went up from there. And this chunk of blues and greens there in similar branch, changing to yellows and reds. So we could have a couple of more of these and then maybe some turnaround from there. Because this is now the spread of the OI call and put has increased even more sharply. So essentially a lot of writing has happened, but that won't last for long because this OI spread at its lowest level here in the last 3 months. So it does, the spread does tend to mean revert. And the moment we start seeing that happening, we could see some turnaround there. Tata Motors, reds, yellows, similar gap, and it's kind of unwinding here, and maybe some cooling off could happen. Asian Paints, classic case of what we are telling. In the futures, there were long build-up, couldn't last for long. The first turnaround became a blue, and you see, reds converted to blues, greens, similar thing. Still showing in the phase of blues and greens, but a couple of reds have come in. So showing some, maybe short build-up trying to, the bears trying to get in. But let's see how it moves from there. Because at this bottom, there was some major chunk of delivery which happened here. And the RSI, which was oversold, it rose from there. And the ADX, you can see this gap also reducing. So now it's in a narrow zone and let's see where it goes from there. But the point of all these things together is you get a real good perspective of all the FNO parameters that you need to see to get exactly a good picture of what's happening in the market. Bharti Airtel, why falling, PCR stable, nothing of surprising, just some greens, but that's it. No major sharp rise in OI. Dr. Reddy, interesting. Sharp price rise, PCR rise, big volume spike there in calls. And these greens and blues, a chunk of greens and blues, maybe it could find some resistance here from where it fell previously. If it breaks this, then maybe it could rise higher. But yeah, it's at a important zone. So let's see where it moves from there. HDFC Life. Rise, a couple of reds and yellows, but yeah, it's still, the spread is kind of flattening. So maybe the weakness still abounds. We need some better indication of when it could turn around. Junk, Bajaj Finance, nothing special, Axis Bank. PCR falling, show the spread, but again, major thing, CL Tech, major, this blues followed by, you know, a couple of yellows, yeah, Tata Consumer does, is kind of correcting, but you can see this nice hammer there, so maybe it's trying to turn around, yeah, Tata Consumer is trying to turn around, because this PCR is kind of falling though. Let's see, OI is really reduced considerably. So all the positions, majority of the positions are out. M&M, interesting. UPL, PCR rising and chunk of 5-6 blues and price rise, greens rise, first signs and a yellow which was happening. And it happened at a resistance zone, a first red candle. So UPL after this rise, maybe we could see some correction happening here. OI reducing, sharply to its lows. IndusInd Bank, nothing surprising here. Chunk of blues converting to first yellow. Some short covering which happened after the initial fall, but maybe it may not sustain, and could still see some further weakness. Tech Mahindra, chunk of blues, first yellow. Could maybe fall from there. Sun Pharma, LT, chunk of blues and full of reds and yellows coming in, so maybe some weakness which could come in. The short covering which was there, you're also seeing some unwinding now happening. And PCR spread also, nothing sharp. Coal India, interesting, blues, greens, greens. Small yellow, but it's not a sharp change in OI. And the PCR also steady, so it could get interesting. Let's see where Coal India moves from there. Cipla, OI falling, yellows, and some red also. This OI spread also decreasing. So weakness still there. Let's see if it can try and gather some strength from there. Hero Motoko, nothing. This green, yellows. Bajaj Auto trying to break out from this narrow range, and you can see if after a few yellows and a green offshoot coming in. So trying to pick up from there, but some major call writing here happening at 3700 levels. So that is a strong resistance zone. PCR falling sharply. These lab correction kind of happening. After this blues, the first chunks of yellows and stuff where it's kind of unwinding. So DV's lab showing some selling pressure there. Shamota, the call OI put spread gap is just increasing the direction. Major NTPC, blues and greens, the chunk first red, so it could see some, and which is at its maximum OI also. Call OI maximum is at 135, so maybe we could see some selling pressure here for NTPC. IOC, after this rise, two strong reds, in fact, now correcting from here. So let's see if it could go down further from there. Power Grid, narrow range. Blues and greens in the first signs of red, but PCR also increasing and the OI spread also increasing. So it's like a tussle between the bulls and bears. If it rises from here, let's see how it went intraday. Yeah, it's trying to go up. If it tries to break this level, it could rise higher. SBI Life, four yellows followed by blue, a short covering. So it's trying to break out from here. Let's see, in fact, the OI spread also kind of increasing steadily. Britannia, this is interesting. Four reds, one offshoot of blue, and it's at its support zone. So Britannia, and in fact, you can see the OI spread also turning around. This is a nice case where you can see the red reducing but the green increasing. So it's like a double whammy, and we could probably see a temporary bounce back of Britannia from here. And some, yeah, nice delivery here also. So let's see how that goes. And in fact, even the RSI is showing some divergence here, kind of a divergence. So let's see. ONGC, greens and blues followed by one red. So time for it to maybe correct from here. And she's greens, blues followed by red and yellow, some weakness there. And the spread also kind of flattening. So yeah, let's see how it all goes from here. But and if you don't sometimes want to go through each of these charts, what you can also do is see by these quick signals, which you can see again in the diamond plan. So you want to see where the price is breaking the SMA 50, for example. Here you can see TCS, easier to see. Blues then followed by the first red, maybe some weakness here. Likewise, IOC also, it's breaking here this SMA. And you can have a combine of the two. You want to see the price which is near the lower range of that 3-month time frame what we've selected. Lever, for example, it's near the lower range, 5 percentile. And OI is near the higher percentile. And you can do a combination of the two also. So that will give you an idea of where... this OI high range. So here it's showing you where OI is really high and the price is near its low. So maybe a chance of this OI starting to cover. You can see where the OI call total is near its high range, for example. So here you can see this Kotak Bank OI call is near its highest range, which maybe some major short build up, which again they could start covering because they are at its high levels. You want to see some resistance unwinding. Essentially the max call OI is being covered. So here, after, for example, HDFC Bank, in fact this could be just profit booking here in this case. The spread rising, spread falling, there are a lot of things which signals which are there, and we are adding some more signals and even some more code filters also, which you should soon see coming in the next couple of months also. So yeah, hope you got an idea how we could actually analyze charts, and FNO data does give you another perspective. In fact, we always like to say it's open interest, especially is like the third eye. It actually shows you the positions people are actually sleeping on overnight. So when the water is really boiling and it's like it's going to blast one way. So either the bulls or the bears are going to give in first. And who gives in first, that's what we can probably get an idea seeing this kind of data. So happy FNOing, and hope you like this addition of chart features that we just added, and we just make it all the more powerful. Thank you so much.